and we're going to head into part number two of our balanced yoga sequence, balancing our joints, balancing the lower and upper parts of our body. So this is the upper body component. That's what my brain turned that into. So this one's nice. We can start by just finding a nice seat, facing the short edge of your mat. And this time, we're going to also be doing equal breathing, but we're going to try having a little bit of a pause at the top. So you're going to do 5 seconds breathing in, hold, 5 seconds breathing out. So when you're ready, find your own rhythm, and we're going to get started. As we begin, I want you to keep your breath work in mind, and this part of the two-part series is very focused on joints, ligaments, making sure that we stretch, and giving our upper body some love. So we're going to start with something that I at least think is very fun, and we're working our way from the lower back up, and that is rolling like a ball. So all that you're doing is using momentum to roll back and forth. If you're pregnant or if you have specific low back issues, I'd probably suggest skipping this one. And you can just sit in a cross-legged position and roll in circles. It'll give you the same type of massage, or you can lay on your back and go from side to side. And now, this one, I want you to get a lot of momentum because I want you to come up and over into a standing forward. And now because this forward fold, we're really looking to get the stretch in our back, you can give yourself a nice bend in your knees. You don't have to have perfectly straight legs for this. The biggest part that we're making sure that we're getting a good stretch in is that back. So giving yourself a nice generous bend in your knees a lot of times will help make sure that that's where you're feeling the stretch. Now I want you to straighten your right leg, bend your left leg, and reach your right hand up to the sky, getting a nice spinal twist. And the other side. Straighten left leg, bend right leg. Come back down and forward. Now, I just want you to rock a little bit side to side. Ready, root to rise. We're going to go through a sun salutation. Hands down, step, hop, or float, cobra pose. Warm up through the core. Those are the muscles that support our lower back. So to have good spine health, you have to have a nice, strong core. Upward dog. Through that back, and now you're going to come down into an all fours position, and we're going to head into puppy pose. So from this all fours position, you're going to walk your hands out and to the edges of your mat before bringing your forehead down towards the mat. Now I want you to lift up, bring your left arm to the center of the mat, open through your right arm, underneath. We're going to do that two more times. Up and under. Last time. Up and under. Thread that needle, reach that arm through, and stretch through that upper body. Now his arms back out. Into that puppy pose. And now we're going to do the same thing that we did on that other side. Bring the right arm to the center. Bring it down and under. Extend that left arm to the ceiling. Bring it down and under. Last time. Extend up. Thread that needle. This one always feels so good. Really helps with any tension in the upper back, especially if you sit at a desk all day. Feels really nice. Or if you have young kids, you're always picking them up. Okay. From here, come back up. We're going to do another round of cat-cow. This move is so important to spinal health. But this time, you can come forward and up. Give it a little bit of life. Really move to loosen anything that's tight in that back. And be playful about it. This is your practice. Do whatever feels good for you. And then you're just going to come all the way down. Warm up our upper back. We're just going to do 5 back extensions. And then you're going to come up and do cobra pose or sphinx pose. Keep your head nice and neutral. You can look to one shoulder, and then the other. Then you can lower back down. Come into a nice low cobra. And hold here. Wherever, whatever a low cobra means to you. Lower down. A little bit of a higher cobra. Down. And if you're ready for it, finally ending with upward facing dog. From there, press up and back, downward facing dog. Chaturanga, upward facing dog, downward facing dog, slow walk up to the front of your mat, bring those feet together, you can start warming up through your wrists. Stepping on those hands up to the wrist and then pulling back a little bit. You feel a nice stretch in your back. And from there, slowly make your way down onto your seat. And you're going to cross your legs and head into some circles. Just some nice, comfortable circles. Working to get out any kinks from a different direction. Switch directions. Other way. Okay. Now you're going to bring your right hand to your left knee. You're going to do a nice open twist backwards. hunch back into a bit of a chest stretch. And you can come down and forward if that feels comfortable, or stay wherever you feel comfortable. Just starting to warm up through our chest. Switch the cross of your legs and head back into those circles. Seeing if it might feel a little bit different depending on which leg is in front. You might want to also experiment with the size of your circles. Different size circles will hit different parts of your back. Spinal flexibility really is so important. Same thing, but start the opposite direction. So I want to make sure that we're wringing out our spines, we're getting any tension out, we're making sure that we have full range of motion and flexibility in every direction of your spine. Twist on your side. Nice open twist, you can really start getting into your chest that way. Together. One more time with that chest stretch. Push those shoulder blades together behind you, open. Now turn towards the long side of your mat. You're going to bring one leg up and over the other. It doesn't matter which one you start with. And then you're going to hook your elbow around it and use that to get a nice, a little bit deeper stretch than the first one, a nice spinal twist. If you feel ready, you may be able to hook the arm underneath and through the leg and hold on to the hand this way. But figure out whichever way you feel like you're getting a deeper stretch. Switch the legs. Hook. And make sure that arm is as close to your back as it can be. The one that you're turning with. Slowly, with your legs bent back and forth, to open up through your middle and upper back. Before we do our first big back bend, we've done inversions with the downward facing dog, but this is going to be our first big back bend in this two-part series. And just as important as it is to bend one way, the inversion, you have to bend the other way too. So we're prepping for camel. You're gonna put your toes underneath your feet. I have a block here in case I need some extra support. You're gonna start by pressing through your back and just see how that feels for you at first. Then if you feel ready, you're gonna bring your hands back towards your heels. Start to feel dizzy, come out of it. For 3, 2, hands back on the lower back. Child's pose. Give yourself a minute after the inversions. I know that those can be difficult. But it's so good to go against the way that we're always bending our back. Back up. And we're just going to make big circles from an all fours position. Other direction. And now you're going to droop through your shoulders, push up and out of your shoulders. Droop, up and out. Like cat-cow, but it's just for your upper back and chest. Push and out. Push and out. 2, 1. Press up and back. Downward facing dog. press up and back for a chest stretch, and if you feel comfortable, you can bring it all the way forward. When you're ready, bring your arms down your back, and then slowly stand up one vertebra at a time. Come to Tadasana, take a second. Reestablish your base, take a minute, breathe. From here on out, they're very small stretches. The only things that we have left to stretch are our wrists, our forearms, and our neck, so very small movements. So you can come down onto your seat, and I suggest finding a really comfortable position. We're gonna be here for a little while. If that means that you're up on a block, feel free, do whatever is gonna make you feel the most comfortable. Okay, so we're going to start by just doing some nice wrist circles. Do a couple last shoulder stretches. Pull your arm back and in. You can look over that opposite shoulder to start to stretch through that neck. Hand up and down. Stretch through those triceps. I told you I didn't want to forget any muscles. Switch sides. Bring the other arm across. Get a nice stretch. Hand up and back for a nice tricep stretch. Switch directions. And now you're going to point your hand towards the front of the room, and you're just going to pull your thumb back towards your face, very gently, not super hard, just to stretch in a different way than we're used to. Bring the hands together. Press them in and together. If you can, you can come to a version of Goddess or of a nice low Malasana squat. You don't have to fully be squatting. You can take it in a restorative pose and sit down on the blocks. The important thing is that you use the leverage from your legs to be able to open up nice and tall in your chest. Release that. Bring your other hand forward. Stretch up through those fingers. Stretch back and in, stretching the other part of your forearm. And now switch directions. And you're going to pull your thumb back to stretch out that meaty part of your thumb. Now you're just going to take your hands. Might be easier to show you this way. You're going to take your hands. Press back into them with your fingertips pointed in towards your body. Flex your neck down towards your chest. Take this opportunity to either continue to breathe, or if you want an opportunity for another inversion like camel, you can come up, if it's in your practice, into wheel pose. Lower back down nice and slow, nice and easy. Also now take the opportunity, if it's in your practice, to work on shoulder stands. Or you can come over into what I've heard is called plow pose, a great stretch for the back of your neck. Those always feel really good. It's a great way to switch your perspective too. If you're having a weird day or something, that's a great thing to do. Now again, come into a nice restorative position. And we just have that neck to contend with. So give some shoulder rolls back. And then the other direction, forwards. Take a deep breath and slowly bring your chin down towards your chest. Lift up and lift back towards the ceiling. Down towards your chest. And up. Look left. Look right. Look left. Look right. Come back to center. Bring the hands behind the neck. Touch the fingers as you bring your chin down towards your chest. Open and press back. Down and in. Open and back. Not putting a ton of pressure on your neck. Bring the neck to the right if you'd like. You can add a little bit of extra stretch by extending that opposite arm. Up and over. Very gentle with our necks. Letting them work out at their own rate. Now look down towards the left part of your chest. Down towards the right part of your chest. Come up and find a comfortable position for your Shavasana. We're going to do the same thing that we did, the equal breathing, the five in, hold, five out. You can breathe out of your nose this time. If you want to, you can follow along with me. I'm choosing to spend a little bit of time before I head down to the mat, massaging my massaging that fascia. You know, our feet do support us and they deserve to get just as much love as everything else. And then when you're ready, make your way down onto your mat. You can take how long of a Shavasana you want. This is as much time as I have, so remember, like I told you, the five holds, five, and just try to do 10. Thank you guys so much. This is Kat, strong, not skinny. And this is the second part of our balancing yoga flow. I hope that you guys enjoy it. And please let me know if you want to see more things like this. I'll be happy to post it. And let me know if there's anything that you want to see that you haven't been seeing. So thank you guys so much. Thank you for being part of this community. And I'll talk to you guys soon.